देश के किसानों को हर वो साधन संसाधन दिए जाए जिससे वो वर्ष 2022 तक अपनी आय दोगुनी कर सके।
India is a country of contrast, a country known for its diversified geographical, ethnic, cultural, linguistic, political, economic, and religious panorama. The cultural heritage has recorded history of more than 4,500 years. Agriculture and farming is one of the key aspects of India's diversified outlook. Farmers residing in more than 7 lakh villages rigorously sweat to satisfy the hunger of 1.3 billion population of India. This is a hard truth that farmers of India are the torchbearers of national prosperity. Since the last two decades, there is a massive decline seen in farming due to immense and constant price hike in necessary infrastructure, drop in cultivation due to inconstant weather conditions, and minimal reach of farmers to the market. These distressing and alarming constraints in traditional farming instigates many challenges for farmers to continue farming as a profession. Today, there is a distinctive and incredible change noticed after persistent restructuring of Indian agricultural setup. This change is continuously motivating deprived farmers, and they are mutually getting connected with new dimensions introduced in Indian agriculture. Remarkable change is observed in farmers' adaptations of the new practices, techniques and information, right from the use of seeds to the market's needs. Communication gap amongst distant farmers is thinning, with the use of mobile phones giving them a platform to discuss innovative and risk-free ways in all weather conditions. Crucial information about soil testing, balanced use of pesticides and fertilizers, advantageous crops and new government schemes is now reaching the farmers by means of various persuasive communication methods. Farmers are regularly benefited with government schemes of sustainable agriculture, irrigation, insurance, storage, market, and financial needs directly, with an aim to support them in all possible means. Along with such schemes, rapidly progressing science and technological developments is also playing a vital role in increasing farmers' income, giving them financial stability. Use of information technology, advanced irrigation systems, plant biotechnology, automated harvesting machinery, and weather projection systems have given much opportunity to farmers to inherit modern agricultural standards. Among all latest science and technological developments in agriculture, there is a technique under plant biotechnology which has been revolutionary technological advancement to increase farmers' income and enrich prosperous lives. This groundbreaking scientific innovation technique is called as plant tissue culture. However, this technique was invented in early years of the last century in Germany and was commercially introduced in India in the year 1987. Since then, continuous studies have been conducted to make it as a commercial success, bringing it in mainstream agricultural practices. Today, there are more than 200 tissue culture companies in India, producing more than 500 million plantlets per year with 80 million certified plant species. Plant tissue culture has been very advantageous in many ways. Conservation of endangered plants, rapid production of mature plants, production of multiples of plants, production of clone copies of plants for desirable traits, production of disease-free plants, and mass propagation of plants for commercial use are some of the major advantages of plant tissue culture. With India's increasing demand for agricultural, forestry, plantation, and horticulture crops, the need of high-quality, high-yielding, and disease-free plantlets has also increased considerably. Plant tissue culture has emerged as an important biotechnological and commercially viable mode to multiply elite varieties of plants rapidly in specialized laboratories, irrespective of the season round the year. Among many plant species on which plant tissue culture technique has been scientifically stimulated and cultivation has been reported, banana is the crop which has gained maximum popularity. This is because of the high yield and highest profits, especially in regions where banana was minimally cultivated.
Through tissue cultures, you can produce a large amount of similar kind of plants what actually farmers need, and then you can just grow your plants through in your farms or in your lands, and you can just have your crops ready. Tissue culture is getting huge momentum, and one thing is that cultural cycle is not there. You can produce throughout the year through tissue culture, so that is a very interesting part.
Banana produced by tissue culture plants are uniform in color, shape, size, and large in quantity. Scientifically, they are disease free and can also be maintained by proper crop management practices. Banana production goes round the year by tissue cultured plantlets. It gives uniform maturity of the banana fruit in time, which makes its harvesting process easy with reduced labor costs. The cultivation time of tissue culture banana plantlets is considerably less than traditional banana cultivation by means of suckers. These favorable facts motivate farmers to adopt banana cultivation as their major crop. In Uttar Pradesh, many farmers have admirably adapted plant tissue culture technique in banana cultivation and have made remarkable increase in their income. Among many such farmers, Shri Ram Saran Verma from district Barabanki, Uttar Pradesh, is a progressive farmer who is known for his enthusiasm in farming, specifically in banana cultivation. For his extravagant approach in spreading awareness about profitable high-tech farming to small farmers, he was awarded with India's fourth civilian award, Padma Shri, by Honorable President of India. He was one of the first farmers to introduce tissue culture in Uttar Pradesh.
इसके पौधे क्योंकि एक लैब में तैयार होते हैं, एक साइंस से विज्ञान की विधि से तैयार किए हैं, तो इसके पौधे सारे यूनिफॉर्म होते हैं, एक साथ हमारे खेत में फल देते हैं, एक जैसी पैदावार देते हैं। जो पुरानी पद्धति थी वही सकर से पुत्ती से जो कल लगा रहे थे, उसका फल छोटा बड़ा और एक जैसा यूनिफॉर्म नहीं आता था, कि जो हमारी फसल 15 महीने में होती थी वो 11 से 12 महीने में होने लगी। तो ये टिश्यू कल्चर के बहुत सारे फायदे हैं।
As per his experience of two decades in farming, banana cultivation by tissue culture technique is very much beneficial in many ways. The investment of traditional banana farming and plant tissue culture is approximately same, but there is a huge difference in yield. Taking 1 acre of land and 1200 banana plants into consideration, the profit difference between tissue culture banana cultivation and traditional banana plantation of suckers is approximately 1.5 lakh rupees. Farmers review this profit and are investing towards tissue culture banana cultivation. There are various types of active banana species which can be cultivated by tissue culture technique. They vary on the basis of geographical outset. Amongst them, species which has gained farmers' preference is Grand 9, commonly known as G9 banana. G9 banana, being cost effective, carries good quality bunches, uniform yellow color with better shelf life. The cost of G9 tissue culture banana plantlet varies from state to state. Majority of labs are in the state of Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu and Gujarat. In Uttar Pradesh, average cost of one banana plantlet is 15 to 16 rupees. In 1 acre land, it would only cost 18 to 20,000 rupees for banana plantlets. This cost may be too high for marginal farmers, but they also can plan their routine cultivation with banana to stabilize their financial needs. This way, they can double their income by colonizing their land with banana and other crops. With the help of government aids, many farmers in remote areas of Lucknow are solely interested in tissue culture banana cultivation.
पहले हमारे यहाँ आलू, गेहूँ, धान यही सब होता था और सब्जी का काम होता था। जैसे हम आलू की खेती करते हैं तो उसमें पर बीघे में उसका मुनाफा करीब 15 से 20 हज़ार रुपये रहता है। आलू से अच्छी फसल है केले की। लागत तो ज़्यादा है केले में, मगर मुनाफा भी आलू से ज़्यादा है। केला लगाने में करीब 30 से 35 हज़ार रुपये खर्चा आता है, लेकिन उसका मुनाफा जो रहता है वो 70 से 80 हज़ार रुपये पर बीघे का रहता है। टिश्यू कल्चर में आराम यह है कि लागत कम आती है पौधे की, अच्छा फल मिलता है और उसके वजह से मुनाफा भी अच्छा मिल जाता है। जितने किसान हैं सभी लोग लगाने लगे हैं और केला ही यहाँ की मेन फसल हो गई है।
The banana cultivation is widely spreading from one farmer to another due to its high profit and good income prospects. For a better banana cultivation, certain measures are very much important. Preparation and flattening of land, proper drainage system of rainwater, cultivation time of banana species used, weather information, irrigation system if required, source slab of plantlets, needed fertilizers, labor management and concept of crop cycle. Among these key important aspects, crop cycle is very much important for farmers to understand. Crop cycle is a concept to maintain the fertility of land, as not all of the same nutrients are being used by each crop in each season. This also means that repetition of a crop on the same land and soil will degrade itself in terms of quantity, shape and yield obtained. It is important to test the soil in specialized laboratories time to time in order to maintain soil's nutrient level and fertility. Banana cultivation crop cycle also helps in decreasing the use of fertilizers and pests. Farmers should understand these key concepts to generate more income, increasing the yield.
सबसे बड़ा फायदा जो फसल चक्र का है, 30% उत्पादन बढ़ता है। जहां हमारा केले का उत्पादन 300 कुंटल है, गेहूं के बाद हम केला लगाते हैं तो हमारा पैदावार केले की 400 कुंटल हो जाती है। केला काट करके हम आलू लगाते हैं, कोई खाद देने की ज़रूरत नहीं है। तो फसल चक्र के ये हमारे लाभ हैं। खाद भी बचेगी, उत्पादन भी बढ़ेगा। 50,000 से ज़्यादा किसान हमारे टिश्यू कल्चर को हमने टेक्निक सिखाई है। हम ज़्यादा तो कुछ नहीं कहते, उत्तर प्रदेश की क्रांति केले से ही हुई।
टुडे उत्तर प्रदेश इज कल्टिवेटिंग मोर देन 20% ऑफ बनाना एंड 80% इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय अदर स्टेट्स लाइक महाराष्ट्र, तमिलनाडु एंड गुजरात। इन उत्तर प्रदेश बनाना कल्टिवेशन इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट प्रॉमिसिंग कल्टिवेशन व्हेन कंपेयर्ड टू शुगर केन व्हिच वाज वाइडली कल्टिवेटेड इन द स्टेट। ड्यू टू डिलेड मार्केट बेनिफिट्स फ्रॉम शुगर केन, many farmers from marginal or lower income grades have experienced huge income gain by switching to tissue culture banana cultivation, and this is rapidly expanding its popularity day by day, making the prime minister's vision turn into reality.
ganne mein aapko zyada se zyada aamdani, ek ekad mein ganna aapka 300 kuntal paida ho jayega, 90 se 95000 rupaye ka 1 lakh rupaye ganna hoga, kela 4 lakh rupaye ka hoga, खर्चा 35 से 40 हज़ार गन्ने में आ रहा है, 60 हज़ार फायदा होगा। केले में नेट इनकम 2.5 लाख, 2 लाख होगी। जो किसान हमारे यहाँ काम करते थे, आज वो एक एकड़ में जिनकी आमदनी 10,000 नहीं थी, आज उनकी आमदनी 4 लाख है एक एकड़ में केला लगा करके। फिर धीरे धीरे हमारे पास के किसानों ने लगाया। 50 से 60 हजार किसान हैं जो केले की टेक्निक से जुड़े हैं।
टिश्यू कल्चर हैज नाउ बीन अ स्कोप ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरस एग्रीकल्चर प्रैक्टिस इन इंडिया एंड हैज टेकन इट्स प्लेस इन इंडियाज डेवलपमेंट स्पेशली इन फार्मिंग। दिस वॉज नॉट पॉसिबल विदाउट द इंटरवेंशन ऑफ आर साइंटिस्ट एंड प्लांट बायोटेक्नोलॉजिस्ट। Their rigorous hard work and continuous researches in plant tissue culture has opened gateways of success to the farmers. This success makes us curious to know the science behind the tissue culture technique. For this quest to unfold the scientific approach which has transformed many lives, we went to CSIR NBRI, National Botanical Research Institute located in Lucknow. NBRI has a rich history in scientific development of tissue culture technique. For 3 decades, scientists here have researched on various plant species on which tissue culture can be carried out. For the extensive contribution of scientists, NBRI has been awarded by National Technology Award in the year 2000. Conservation of endangered plants is also made possible by means of tissue culture. These contributions by scientists have made tissue culture possible from lab to field.
Tissue culture is utilized for the last 50 years, okay? And it is one of the amazing techniques in biotechnology. In agriculture, it actually changes the parameters and it actually benefits the farmers. There are several crops are cultivated through tissue culture, mainly banana. So all these things are produced through tissue culture. Large business houses which are producing the Ayurvedic medicines, they are taking the plants from the field. They are actually destroying the biodiversity. So if you produce those tissue culture plants in your field and sell them to the business house, so you can earn a lot of money. There are a lot of species are categorized as a endangered species. These all species are have been tissue culture, successfully tissue cultured and conserved.
Now, undoubtedly, it can be said that tissue culture is a revolutionary scientific technique by which farmers in India are progressing towards prosperous life and we are conserving the endangered plant species which are of great use to mankind. Not only in banana cultivation, tissue culture is also spreading in cultivation of plants which are categorized as medicinal plants. Additionally, special emphasis is also given to cultivate flowers, fruits and vegetables by means of tissue culture technique. Scientific measures are taken by NBRI to increase the cultivation of plants by tissue culture technique. Special training sessions and seminar are organized by NBRI regularly to aware the farmers about latest techniques in cultivating ornamental flowers and medicinal plants.
जो नई नई रिसर्च होती है, नई नई टेक्नोलॉजी तैयार की जाती है, तो किसानों को हम इसलिए करते हैं ताकि वो उससे फायदा उठा सके। और किसानों के लिए हम लोग संगोष्ठी भी करते हैं और उनकी ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम का भी कार्यक्रम रखते हैं। हमारे यहाँ जो ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम होते हैं उनमें सब में टिश्यू कल्चर की ट्रेनिंग हम लोग उनको सिखाते हैं, जिससे कि वो टिश्यू कल्चर कैसे किया जाता है। बुलेट ही है जो बहुत कॉमन है, इस सीज़न में जाड़े के सीज़न में काफ़ी यूज़ होती है, कफ सीरप में यूज़ होती है। इसका खेती काफ़ी लोग कर रहे हैं, सिट्रस पे भी लोग काफ़ी इंटरेस्ट दिखा रहे हैं। सिट्रस दो तरीके से फ़ायदेमंद है, एक तो फ्रूट उसका फ़ायदेमंद है और दूसरा मेडिसिनल प्लांट भी है वो। तो इसमें किसान उसकी तरफ भी काफ़ी जागरूक हो रहा है और उसकी तरह अग्रसित भी हो रहा है।
After acknowledging such wonders by tissue culture technique, it is now important to know the process of plant tissue culture technique. The tissue culture technique begins with the selection of a mother plant, cutting out the explant from the mother plant, washing the explant in running water, removal of contaminants by special solutions, shifting of explant to laminar airflow, surface sterilization by prescribed chemicals, inoculation of explant, shifting of culture to culture room, in vitro development of explant, subculturing and separation of in vitro shoots, transfer of shoots to rooting medium, and lastly, transferring of polyhouse for hardening procedures. The natural feature of any plant to grow from any part of the plant tissue is called as plant cell totipotency. It is an ability of a plant cell to divide and produce all of the differentiated cells in an organism.
One important thing is that one term is very important, that is totipotency. Now, what is totipotency? Totipotency means the ability of a plant cell to regenerate the whole plant. So that is we call totipotency, and tissue culture technique of the plants depends solely on this aspect.
Based on this natural phenomena of any plant tissue, whole procedure of tissue culture is devised. There are some scientific terminologies which need to be explained, like what is micropropagation, mother plant, explant, inoculation, in vitro fertilization, and true to type plant. Micropropagation means the process by which mass multiplication or production of large number of plants from small pieces of the mother plant. Mother plant is the scientifically distinctive source plant by which small tissues can be obtained. Explant is the scientific term of the small tissue fetched out from the mother plant. Inoculation is the process of transfer of the explant to nutrient medium. In vitro fertilization means fertilization of plant in an artificial condition made as similar as natural conditions. True to type means the identical clone features of the new plant as the mother plant.
Tissue culture is a technique that the plant portions of any part, leaf, leaf, tana, fool, या रूट हो, जड़ हो उसकी, तो उस सब से हम लोग टिश्यू कल्चर से एस्टेब्लिश करके उसको बना सकते हैं। ये एक ऐसी टेक्निक है जिससे हम प्लांट के किसी भी पार्ट से उसको हम प्लांट तैयार कर सकते हैं। और जो टिश्यू कल्चर टेक्निक से हम मदर प्लांट से हम उसका कल्चर करेंगे तो बिल्कुल ट्रू टू टाइप प्लांट तैयार हो, क्लोन जैसा। कम समय में ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा पौधे हम टिश्यू कल्चर मेथड से तैयार कर सकते हैं।
द प्रोसेस ऑफ बनाना टिश्यू कल्चर स्टार्ट्स विद द सिलेक्शन ऑफ मदर प्लांट। The mother plant should be healthy, disease-free, with minimum irregularities, carry good characteristics, and must have given good yield. After selection of the mother plant, chosen explant is separated from the mother plant. The explant separation process should be carried out keeping in mind the basic physiology and morphology of plant. Preliminary precautions are taken into consideration while doing this procedure. Just after this, the explant is washed by running water thoroughly so that the soil remains. Dirt or any type of infection does not come with it. Peeling off unwanted portion is necessary to clean the explant completely. The next step is putting the freshly separated and washed explant in distilled water to secure it from contamination and dehydration. Next step occurs in lab where the explant is sheared as per need. Auxiliary bud present in the explant can be seen, which will instigate further lab procedures to get a perfect explant for tissue culture. The explant is washed in running water for at least 30 minutes. Further, it is treated in liquid soap and antiseptic solution to avoid any fungal infection and contamination coming from field environment. Stirring of the solution is done clockwise and anti-clockwise to remove dust particles from the explant. It is then re-washed several times for prescribed time duration in distilled water to remove the remains of chemical. Process is repeated until all the solution gets drained out from the surface of the explant. Parallel to these procedures, a medium is made for upcoming inoculation process. Medium is referred as the plant tissue culture nutrient medium in which the explant will be inoculated. The steps for preparing media is mixing of prescribed nutrients, maintaining optimum pH, pouring in bottles, sealing and sterilization in autoclaves.
In plant tissue culture media, you can just divide it into three or four parts. There is macronutrients, micronutrients, vitamins and sugars. Macronutrients are those which are necessary for their growth. For example, phosphorus, nitrogen, ammonium, all these things are very essential. For micronutrients, you need molybdenum, copper, and also for sugar source, you need sucrose or maltose. And apart from these, you need vitamins as well as plant growth regulators.
As the media is prepared and made ready for inoculation, explant reaches the laminar airflow for inoculation. The laminar airflow maintains continuous air current, which keeps the activity without the risk of contamination. It is properly UV sterilized, and the equipments used here are pre-autoclaved for deep sterilization. Autoclave is a device by which the equipments are sterilized in heavy temperature. Here, the expert technician treats the explant with a disinfectant chemical solution several times to remove any remaining bacteria. It is then further shredded into fine pieces for exposing perfect explant. Due care is taken while doing this process, as it may harm the inner important portion of the explant. Further, it is then placed in the sterilized nutrient media kept ready for the explant. This is further denoted as cultures. Now the culture is shifted to the culture room, also referred as growth room. Here, typical prescribed temperature is maintained from 25 to 28 degrees centigrade. Optimum humidity and timed artificial light arrangement are maintained in culture rooms. Prescribed time of 3 to 5 weeks is given to cultures to develop. Continuous monitoring is also done simultaneously. Thereafter, the period of 3 to 5 weeks, the explant shows the growth in multiple shoots. These shoots are then transferred on the subculture or multiplication medium for further growth of the plants. Several subcultures cycle are carried out in the lab for mass production from the explant. Moving further, the in vitro shoots are separated again in the laminar airflow stations, and these fully grown shoots are transferred to the rooting medium for root induction. This process takes 3 to 4 weeks time for growth and varies from species undertaken for tissue culture. Lastly, when the rooted shoots have proper growth in the culture room, they are then shifted for hardening. The primary hardening process starts by making the plant adapt and adjust with the atmospheric condition in artificial hardening media called as cocopeat. Here, the plants are kept in humidity chambers for acclimatization. Time of 3 to 4 weeks is given to plants to adapt to the controlled conditions. Then the secondary hardening is carried out by putting the plant in the soil, sand and manure for 20 to 25 days. Fertilizers, fungicides, insecticides and growth regulators are sprayed to secure new plants from bacteria and viruses. These are then kept under observation for a prescribed time period. Finally, the plants are ready for farmers for cultivation in the field. In India, the tissue culture technique is now rapidly bringing phenomenal change in the lives of not only of banana farmers, and has identified itself as the forerunner of modern agriculture and high-tech farming.
सबसे ज़्यादा जो टिश्यू कल्चर टेक्निक का लाभ पहुँच रहा है पूरे भारत में किसानों को, तो 60% काले केले से है। केले में ये विधि बहुत ही बड़ी कामयाब, मतलब बिल्कुल सटीक 100% कामयाब। इकोनॉमिक दृष्टि देखें तो सबसे बड़ी कामयाबी है जो हमारा जहाँ तक मानना है, हमने देखा है, काफ़ी लैब वालों से हमने बात किया है, वो सबसे बड़ी कामयाबी केले में ही है।
Today, With the expansion of tissue culture technique, we can notice a huge change in the lives of Indian farmers. This change is slowly pulling the strings of Indian economy towards growth. Farmers are climbing the age-old walls of darkness and are experiencing the bright yellow shine of change. A country's prosperity solely depends on the agricultural reforms which can be seen in the farms. The face of Indian agriculture is also changing from misery to victory. This change may be portrayed gradually, but the ground reality speaks the actuality. India, being the country of contrast, facing all odds, is grooming with its agricultural production increase day by day. Farmers in India struggle day and night. But if supported by us, even worst of the conditions can't break their hopes, strength, and enthusiasm to feed the nation.